Some of you don't know if you're being holy. But anyway, unless you stand to be broken at the risk of losing, let me call it the performance method. Ridiculous. To stand with all, to be careful. This is a pass fail test based on faith in Christ. And so what Jesus is telling the rich young ruler is your standard is broken. Your performance religion is broken. He's also the rich young ruler. He's delusional about how well he's doing. So even if his standard work is correct, he says, "Hey, you've got the commandments that you commit the gods for you. You stole it. And you have done this for the day. It's like, oh, you nailed it." No, you haven't. But then he goes, "Okay, let's say you have it. You should sell everything that you have if you give it all to the poor." What is exposing it is exposing the fact that the rich young ruler had broken the first commandment. You shall have no other gods before you. Money, wealth, status, a pleasure was this man's God. So when Jesus did this, he exposed him and he said, "If you're righteous, you're good to go. Understand it. Sell everything you have. Let me continue your life." What happens? He goes away from it. Not one thing he says. I feel like he's starting. People find me from the beginning of the world. What a thing to kill us. If you can accept this goal in your life, about your life, it's people are absolutely. That's not what it's arrogant about. It's arrogant about making room in your heart before Jesus. The rich young ruler, he didn't have any money. It was clogged up by his pride and idolatry. Money was his king. But he preferred that to Jesus. So he said, "Come out. No thanks." Jesus says, "Come and follow me." The rich young ruler says, "Come and follow me." To be direct. Like every first had to dethrone that rich. He was king over him. So I don't know what that is to you. Maybe you live money and status and power and pleasure and reputation. Maybe it's yourself. I don't know what occupies your mind, what occupies your heart, what are you constantly thinking about? What if you lost it when you make your life almost not worth living? What are you holding on to? Is that tight? The answer to that question is what you're holding on to. If you just call the hope, repent from sin. So, move away from those things and come follow me. If the rich young ruler had sold all of his stuff and became homeless for the rest of his life, that would have been so worth it. To have the treasure of Christ is so much better. So much better. But those are the rich young, I want you to go away from that. When confronted with, when offered with, Jesus, don't go away sad because you prefer your stuff, your idols. Don't go away sad. Jesus is, when we see this throughout the Bible, that he's always faithful to be grateful. He calls us from the state. He tells people who they really are, and it's quiet. It's sweet. Take that look in the mirror. Scripture is like that mirror. You read it. It looks better to you. But the rich young ruler still knows Psalm 14:3. He says this because they all have turned aside. Together they have become corrupt. There's no one who does good, not even one. We need to to know this. The rich young ruler should have known this. It was in his Bible that he claimed to know so well. He said, "I know that it is many ways when I come on to this." And he changed things over to Jesus. But the good news is, John 1:14 says that Jesus was freed from grace and so filled that the word became flesh. He dwelt among us. And his kingdom is over the glory of his only Son from the Father, full of grace and truth. He's got to have the truth because he's Christ. If you want that goodness, it can be found. I have a very hard time seeing my life work around me. Very lucky. I'm not very thankful. So if you ask me what I'm doing, I'll probably call it. I'm trying to figure out how to actually do it because so often I'm blinded by my command. I want it to be that I just know that stuff away. I want it to be that I just can't see myself. I'm still blinded by my command. I'm so blinded that it does. I do my knowing, and so my assumption of myself is that I'm doing well. But God tells me, the Spirit of God shows me so often that I'm not. I hurt people. I didn't hear. But I didn't. But the reason that we don't see ourselves well, we need one another to expose ourselves, and we need the Scriptures. Because I believe that Christ has fallen for us to see who we really are. But don't look down on the rich young ruler. Don't think he's an idiot. He's you. He's me. It's terrible that the children of the Bible are not for us to either emulate or denigrate people, but to see ourselves rightly. We are the rich young ruler. We don't have to go over to God. We don't have to stay on that path. He does tell us his wireless of truth on us. If he just did that, it could have a connection. And that, one way to go, the most way. He does the ultimate grace. He calls the same thing with the rich young ruler. Here's who you really are. You're bankrupt. You'll get it. Take your nail and I'll nail it. Then he's a teacher. And Jesus loves us despite us. There's an opportunity to repent, to turn, that's what that word means, to turn from that which we know that is. Going to the Lord, believing that joy and that power is because we receive Jesus as King, that we come under His kingship. That is great joy for more than anything that the world can provide, more than riches and countries can offer. There's joy that is flowing from them. It's also a look at Psalm 23. We know that it can be done for that story. I could try to explain to you the massive benefit that his kingship on earth. That's what God's word will do a great job. So I want you to look at this familiar psalm if you're at the church of today. And I want you to just consider just what it is like with Jesus as it could be kind of like a good shepherd. So if you read this, I want you to consider the kingship of Jesus. It says, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He provides me. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Jesus will sanctify me. He will make me more righteous. He will lead me in paths of righteousness spiritual disciplines. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, the comfort that Jesus will deliver me. From death, an eternal life that with the reason of ruin so badly wanted, he said, how do I get eternal life? Thank you.